1197, take two, pick up. And action?
Yes, sir. I'm going to be a nanny instead.
But, Miss Jelly, I thought you had to be a mummy first.
Here's a scene being recorded with Stanley Baxter and Pat Coombs.
Mr Majeika, no. A nanny is someone who looks after other people's little darlings.
Oh, really?
Yes, and I'm hoping to look after a little darling. School cottage.
Yeah, watching us. Have you actually been filming some of us being filmed?
Yeah, we've been watching you.
The film of the film, in fact.
That's right. We wanted to make to show how it's actually done. So,
yes. Well, I think that is of interest to people. I know that I used to love as a kid watching that happen. Mm. Sometimes a bit of shorts on the screen. When you went to see the feature film, you'd get the news, and then you would get a thing about Hollywood itself.
Yeah.
And that was almost my favourite thing. Although I was daft about the movies anyway. I was a great, great film buff as a child. I lived for those.
What sort of things?
Oh, everything. The RKO, Rogers and Astaire, the Humphrey Bogarts. Not so much the Westerns, funnily enough. I wasn't so keen on that. But I loved the pictures.
Do you think you'd always rather have been a sort of serious actor then, would you? You think it would have been much more...
Well, not necessarily a tragic actor, but... Uh-huh. But I was trained in the straight theatre, 3.5 years of Citizens Theatre. I've done 2 West End plays.
Yeah.
So it isn't a departure to do straight parts, or straighter than I did in my own one-hour specials, which is probably what somebody of your age would have in mind.
Yeah, I mean, always remember the Christmas time, the Stanley Baxter Christmas box or whatever.
Yes, that's right. They had different names like that. Big picture show, and etc.
Because this is quite different, really, isn't it? Because I assume in those you probably had much more control because you were much...
Yeah, well, a great deal to do with what items would appear. Uh-huh. One actually dreamt up all the major items in each show oneself. Whereas Jenny McDade has that responsibility with the Majeika series.
But were any of those characters sort of based on people you really knew? Did people...
You mean in my own show?
Yeah.
Oh, yes. They were, but not specifically. I don't quite work that way.
Uh-huh.
I just find myself doing something, creating a character, and it might be weeks later that I realise that I've borrowed a twitch from somebody and a walk from somebody else, and it's an amalgam of different people. Yes, if you do base a character on somebody who is actually alive and well, they never recognise themselves. I used to do a Kelvin side character, a woman, in fact, on the stage in Glasgow. And she came, this friend of my mother's came to see me, and particularly remarked on this character. And she said, that woman that you do, Marjorie, that you call Rosemary Gushford, sounds exactly like the woman next door to me. And she had no idea that it was based directly on her.
So what about the Mr Majeika character? Because that's a whole new ball game, really, isn't it? Although you're into...
Yes, well, I've never done children's drama before, that's for sure. Uh-huh. So that is a very big departure.
How did you prepare for that?
Well, I couldn't do an awful lot of preparation. I'd seen the scripts. I thought the first script was charming. I wasn't so sure about the second one or the third one, but I liked the first one very much. No, and I liked the third one, that's right, but I wasn't so sure about the second. And these were I had to sign a contract before I'd seen any of the rest, the other three. But I did have some input to the series. I did think up the tuft that Twitch is each time he does something magical.
Mm-hmm.
I did think that up, and I thought the costume up and the idea of the large owl-like glasses.
Something that you've set fire to, sir. Brandy, Mrs. Fox. Matches, Mrs. Fox.
The Majeika character isn't that far removed from the stuff you've done before, in as much as that you're still working a comedy way to...
Oh, yes. He's a comedy character.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
What about the children? Do you get recognised a lot now?
Yes, by a younger and younger generation of people who didn't so much recognise me in life. I'm now finding them nudging each other and grinning and sort of pointing across to my table if I'm sitting in a restaurant in London.
And they think you are actually Mr Majeika, don't they?
No, they know very well that I'm not Majeika because I haven't got the gear on. But they recognise the face. It's surprising that behind those very thick spectacle frames and under that wig and everything, they do recognise you, but they do. I mean, not toddlers, but from 6 and 7 upwards, they do.
Do you think there's a bit of you in Majeika?
No, I don't think there's anything of me in any character I play. Otherwise, I couldn't play it. By that, I mean, of course, emotionally, there's obviously you're drawing on your own emotions, your feelings for children and sad moments and everything. You draw on all that kind of thing. But there's, I mean, I'm not remotely like Majeika, and no character I've ever played, either on stage or screen, resembles myself. In fact, if it did, I couldn't play it. I'd have to turn the part down. It has to be very far removed from me physically and everything else. Otherwise, I find it very difficult to do.
Well, thank you very much for talking to us.
It's been a great pleasure. Bye-bye.